Merry Christmas, everybody. God bless you. Oh, come on, we can do better than that. Would you stand with us as we get ready to worship the Lord? I'm Marlinda Ireland. I'm the worship and creative arts pastor here at Christ Church, and we're so happy that you are in our house tonight. It's good because I was just thinking in the back there, it was in the genius of God that he allowed the church fathers so many years ago to establish a day to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ and to have it bring all kinds of people together from all kinds of backgrounds, all kinds of places, all for the purpose of worshiping Jesus. Isn't that amazing? And it's amazing. So I want you to get ready for tonight. Again, we're so glad that you're here. Our concert this year is called Christmas Unwrapped, but we always, say always.
Always.
I like that. That was good and loud. You used your outside voice. We always start the evening off with a time of just worshiping together, lifting up our voices to the Lord. We want to warm up the atmosphere. We want to warm up our hearts so that we can be ready for what God's going to do. So the worship team's going to come, and then Pastor Lionel King, he's our campus pastor tonight, he's going to come, and then we will have Christmas Unwrapped. So do this for me. Put your hands together, and let's get ready to worship the Lord.
Somebody lift a shout up in this place. We worship you, Jesus. We want to see you magnified and lifted up in this place, God. Worthy is your name. Great is your name. Awesome is your name, yeah. Say all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Say, up the song, say all the earth will,
all the earth will shout,
we magnify you, Jesus.
Our hearts will cry, these bones will
say,
sing.
Great are you, Lord.
Great are you, Lord.
Lift up the sound of worship, say all the earth will shout your praise.
All the earth will shout your praise. Oh, oh, oh.
They weren't messing around. They got the night started off correctly. And I'm excited. I am so, so excited for what's in store the rest of this evening, knowing we serve an awesome, awesome, awesome God. Awesome God. Well, before you're seated, would you greet two or three people, say hello, and get comfortable. You'll be with next to them for some time. Everyone here, at least for when the lights were on for about 30 seconds, just a few seconds ago, looks great tonight. You guys look amazing tonight. How many of you are excited to be here this evening and just take in all that's going on? Now, I know some of you may be wondering, where's the playbill? Where's the playbill? What's going on? I want an itinerary, for the rest of the night. I need my GPS to navigate me through the rest of the night. That's a good question. What I want you to do right now, though, is take out your smartphone, go to the App Store, and look for Christ Church USA. If you want a playbill, you can go to the App Store, Christ Church USA. Download our app. Once you download the Christ Church USA app, the first tab that comes up when you open the app is the playbill for this evening. And so if you have a smartphone, why don't you do that now and just to enjoy the rest of the night and help navigate the rest of the night. And if you don't have a smartphone, the person next to you knows what to get you for Christmas. It's time for an upgrade, and there's no reason in 2017. You don't need to go into 2018 with a dumb phone. And I just want to encourage you to go and purchase that smartphone for your own sanity and for a transformed life. Now, with that said, I'm excited about this Christmas Unwrapped theme. And the reason why, if you're not from Christ Church and if you're just kind of visiting and you're a guest, we welcome you. And one thing you would know about our church, and many people know, we start practicing for the Christmas concert back in June. So while you guys are on the beach sipping pina coladas in the Bahamas, they're practicing for the concert in June. And so we get ready, we get geared up, we're excited about what's going on this evening, and we always have a theme that we kind of follow. And this year's theme is Christmas Unwrapped. And when I think about Christmas Unwrapped, I think about often how wrapped Christmas comes every year. Every year it comes wrapped in something. Sometimes it's commercialism. How many people know what I'm talking about? Yeah, commercialism. So when you think of Christmas, you think of, oh man, I need to budget. I need to get these gifts for certain people, so on and so forth. In fact, some of you are distracted right now thinking about what to get at Walmart as soon as you leave here, because Christmas has become wrapped, so commercialized. One of the other ways Christmas comes sometimes is despair, hurt, pain. Because for some of you here, this will be the first time you spend Christmas away from a loved one. This time last year, you may have certain people around your family that relationships are strained, and you may not see them. And so for you, Christmas is a tough time. But what our heart's desire was, whether you're here or the overflow room, what our heart's desire was is to say, hey, let's take a moment in the midst of the hustle and bustle and the busyness of life to center ourselves on what Christmas is all about. And we wanted to unwrap not just what Christmas is about, who Christmas is about in the person of Jesus Christ. So allow yourself to connect through the arts, through the music, through the worship, and really get a sense of and a hold of what is Christmas all about. And the better question, who is Christmas all about? Christ Church, let us get ready to enjoy Christmas Unwrapped.
On the night that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, when Mary gave birth to a son, her firstborn, she wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room in the inn. Shepherds camping in the same neighborhood. An angel had directed them there so that they could celebrate this special birth. Suddenly, that angel returned and stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I am here to announce a great and joyful event. that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town. A Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for. A baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger. The shepherds let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything that they heard. They left running and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. They found the baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. It turned out exactly the way they'd been told. This is how Christ and the gift of Christmas were unwrapped to the shepherds. And now, 2,000 years later, we and the whole world are still rejoicing and celebrating Christmas Unwrapped.
finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. To lay before the King. Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Rum-ba-bum-bum. Rum-ba-bum-bum. So to honor him, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. When we
world in need of rescue, desperate to have someone who can satisfy your longing hearts and give each one a brand new start. A world in expectation,
sets us free. God heard the cry from heaven's throne, and with one word freely sent his own. Unwrap the wonder, unveil the glory, reveal the splendor, and go tell the story of God's holy love. Wrapped in his son, Jesus, he's a gift, he's a gift. Unwrap the wonder, unveil the glory, reveal the splendor, and go tell the story of God's holy love. Wrapped in his son, Jesus, he's a gift, the gift that will never end.
Unwrap the wonder, unveil the Look and see the dawn. You who dwell in deepest shadow, to you light has come. He will break your bonds of sin and crush the chains of death. He will be your soul's defender, joy of every breath. Governments increase.
Born to us a child is born, unto us a son is given, born to us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
Hallelujah.
gave God a thing to be held, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a slave, born in the likeness of man. He was obedient in death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has exalted him, bestowed on him the very name, that at the sound of which all fall, God's own glory shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
He is the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
I feel like I could dance all over town. It's Christmas time, oh my, my, my. What a wonderful time it is for me. I'm internet shopping and mall hopping, making sure that everyone gets their something. It's Christmas time, oh my, my, my. What a wonderful time it is for me. I love how family and friends get together. The little ones have their hearts so set. Mommy, daddy, what do I get? Piece of the cake and granny's homemade rolls. Forget about that tired wind that blew through my soul. It's Christmas time, oh my, my, my. What a wonderful time it is for me. And of course the kids are laughing, and yes, they're smiling, having fun and chasing that dog named Patches. Christmas time, oh my, 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 what a wonderful time it is for me. Old traditions, new commitments, same conviction. Joyfully we celebrate Jesus Christ.
No. For many of us who have received so much from the gift of Christ in our lives, our Christmas Unwrapped message is simple. To unwrap the gift of God is to reveal His love in our daily lives. At the heart of our church is to be an agent of reconciliation by loving people that we encounter along our journey. In 2011, Christ Church established a safe house called the Abigail House for women and children whose lives were endangered by domestic abuse. Tonight, we want to share a special story with you that isn't a familiar Christmas tale, but a story that reveals God's love for His people and how we, the recipients of His love, can be agents of change in our fragile world. Some of the images in the story may be disturbing, but we are thankful to God for those of you who have given generously to see this type of injustice cease. Would you join us in exploring Christmas Unwrapped through the eyes of Natrell, a domestic and drug abuse survivor, and a beautiful young woman whose life is forever changed?
I was born addicted to methadone. I had gotten beaten so badly. I felt like it would be easier for me to die than it would be for me to try. My mom's house was a bona fide drug house, so there was a constant flow of dealers and users in the house. I remember people shooting up on the couch and my mom smoking crack in the bathroom. There was a certain point in time where I hadn't eaten in 3 days and there was no water and I hadn't showered. I was just like, I can't do this anymore. One of the dealers, he had taken an interest in me. He was about 33 at the time, and he had told me, I can help you live a better life. And I moved in with his cousins. I started escorting, prostituting. I did it for a really long time. He controlled every aspect of my life, what I wore, how I got my hair. We had gotten into some type of altercation, and he started hitting me. I started screaming, and I actually ran away with no shoes, is knocking on doors in the middle of this random neighborhood in North Carolina at nighttime. And this guy answered his door, and he called the police, but I wouldn't cooperate with the police. I didn't want to get my pimp in trouble, and I knew that if I did get him in trouble, whatever was going to come to me after was going to be way worse. Police were like, if you're not going to cooperate with us, there's nothing we can really do about it, so we're just going to drop you off somewhere. And they dropped me off at this Greyhound station, but it was right across the street from this church. It was on a college campus, actually, and I remember this lady saw me with no shoes, and she came over and she gave me the shoes right off of her feet, and I will never forget that. I feel like God sent her just to remind me, like, you're not alone. I'm here with you. I know you're going through something right now, but you're not completely alone. I had gotten beaten so badly, so I asked one of my friends, can you please come get me? I'm all the way in Toms River. I know it's a far drive, but I just need to get away. So they came and got me, and I just never looked back. Because I had started prostituting so young, I didn't have a high school degree, I didn't have a license, I didn't have anything that could help me, and trying to get those things seemed so overwhelming. I felt like it would be easier for me to die than it would be for me to try at that point. When I first found out I was pregnant, it kind of didn't absorb right away. Your mom was not a great mom, but your grandmother was a great grandmother, and you need to be the mother that you never had. Like, if I could be half as good of a mother as my grandmother was a grandmother to me, I would feel so successful. All of the bad situations I've been in, there's no reason I should be here other than the fact that my grandmother prayed for me every single day. I feel like stability is a huge part of being able to make sure that Edward doesn't get into the same trap of addiction and poor behavior that has been in my family for years. My mother is an addict, my grandmother was an addict, so we don't really have that much history beyond addicts. It was important for me to dedicate Edward because I wanted him to be associated with God from the start. Like, I know I love him, but I know I can't protect him in the way God will protect him. When Pastor David and Pastor Marlinda prayed over me and Edward and my grandmother, it felt like love. It felt like being wrapped in a blanket of love. There's no other way to describe it. It felt safe and I felt grateful. In that moment, I kind of reflected on the journey I had been on and how far I had come. And to be surrounded by people that I felt were genuinely sending positive energy towards me, I don't think I've ever been around that much positivity at one time coming from so many different people. Being associated with Family Promise and Abigail House, I've been able to get my GED. I'm enrolled in college for human services. I'm actually one semester away from finishing my associates. After that, I hope to go to a four-year school to get my bachelor's. I've received a car, I've gotten my permit, I'm stable. I've gone to therapy and I've worked through a lot of this stuff that I didn't think I'd be able to work through. Christchurch helps me with like paying utilities and the rent being so cheap and the area. This is a wonderful area to live in. The life I'm living now is something that 18-year-old me and 19-year-old me could only pray and wish to have. I would have never thought I'd be in this position, ever.
Mm-hmm.
powerful, powerful story of God's gift to this young lady, Natrell. I was sitting there fighting back tears, seeing what Christmas is all about. And for her, her struggle, her addiction was a life thrown into drugs and promiscuity. And what was unwrapped for her was a gift of love. And she said one of the most powerful moments that spoke volumes to her is when a young lady takes her shoes right off her feet in front of that church and gives her the shoes off her feet to say, here, take these. And that's where she experienced Jesus's love in a very tangible way. When I think about this Jesus, the whole reason why we're here, the whole theme behind the concert, the fact that he is Christmas unwrapped. And what I'm saying is the story of Jesus, I know it's beautiful and we sing these songs and it's celebratory, but there's a reason for that. Because in the bare bones of the story is that in our brokenness, in our chaos, in the darkness in society, there's this gift in the person of Jesus 2,000 years ago that invades our chaos with hope. And in the midst of our chaos in this world, in the midst of our brokenness, in the midst of the hurt, in the midst of the pain and confusion, you see this Jesus, this baby boy in a manger invading chaos with hope and the harmony of heaven for the first time. Earth gets to kiss heaven in the person of Jesus. And we go on to tell this story of hope, this Christmas unwrapping this gift of Jesus, and what he came to bring was salvation, freedom. Freedom from our brokenness, freedom from our sin, freedom from our own distance from God. And very often, we run to things like Natrell. She ran to things, but your things may not be drugs. Your things may not be promiscuity. For some, it may be the two, but for you, it may be work. You're a workaholic, and you think if I just keep chasing this American dream, fulfillment is going to come. Or for some, you're here and you feel like, man, if I just have the perfect relationship, the perfect spouse, then all my hope would be good. Or if I just had the perfect marriage, or if my kids came up and they were these assets to society, that would be great. That's salvation. That's freedom for me. Ladies and gentlemen, what I'm trying to tell you is this. There's nothing wrong with wanting good things or great things or pursuing your vocation, but I am here to tell you that the reason for the season, no matter how cheesy it is the person of Jesus Christ, that he doesn't have to be this person at a distance. He can invade your chaos just like he invaded our chaos 2,000 years ago. And this is not theory for me. This is not something, some story I read in the Bible that's some distant historical narrative. No, this Jesus is alive and well. He was dead and buried, but he rose on a third day. We'll get to Christmas. I mean, we're in Christmas. We'll get to Easter. You can come back in April, but hopefully you'll get it now. But the reality is that Christmas was unwrapped, or this unwrapping of Jesus happened for me as well. This is not off at a distance, some theoretical tale for me. You see, I grew up understanding all the things about God. My mom was a devout follower in a single parent home. She was a praying woman. She would pray and pray and pray. And I was effective at more sin and sin and sin. I mean, I was a quality sinner. Effective. I was an authority on the issue of sin and evil. And the reality is, the Christmas unwrapped this gift of Jesus for her wasn't enough for it to be just her gift. I had to experience it for myself. I was far off from the things of God. So much so, I almost got incarcerated in high school as an accomplice to an attempted murder. I was also involved in sexual promiscuity, and it led me to an abortion clinic. At the age of 18, I was trying things my own way. I was so empty, so broken, and I hadn't unwrapped this gift of Jesus. I knew all about it. You can be here. You can know the story. You can know all the songs we're singing about and still never receive that gift of Him. And I'm there, and I remember, I don't know, some strange reason, it must have been a work of God. I invited a girl on a date to go see Passion of the Christ. That had to be a work of God. By the way, dating advice, go see Passion of the Christ. See how they respond. You'll know if they're the one. And I went to go there, and I'm this kid born and raised in the inner city in Newark, New Jersey, and you're not supposed to cry or anything. You're a tough guy. And I'm watching this Jesus go to the cross on my behalf, this gift, just taking a beating and lashes for my sin, for my brokenness, and there's nothing I can do to save myself in my own capacity. And I'm watching it, and ladies and gentlemen, when I say I'm watching this gift, this Jesus get whipped and lashed for me, man, this tough little guy from Newark, New Jersey, you talk about holding tears. I couldn't hold a tear back. And when I say I was crying, it wasn't like the little trickle. You know which one I'm talking about, like the little tear rolls down? It was the ugly cry. I mean, it's the one, if you have full lips, you know what I'm talking about. You're sucking your bottom lip well. You're like, Jesus, Jesus, you change me, take me, take me, take me. I guess some of you know what I'm talking about. If Jesus didn't make you do it, your mom did with the belt. You understand what I'm talking about. Either or. Jesus or your parents, whoever got you first. But it was the first time I experienced and I said, God, I'm going to stop fighting you. I'm going to stop trying to do things my way. I submit my life to you. And that's when I realized there was nothing I can do to earn the love of God. God is love, and the gift comes just because He's a great gift giver. It's called salvation by grace through faith. There's nothing you can do to earn that gift, to earn His love. There's no amount of good deeds you can do and go on these great humanitarian efforts to earn His love. The word says even our good deeds are filthy rags before a holy God. The only thing that can get you to connect with the Jesus that loves you is grace. And if you're here today and you're saying, Pastor Lionel, man, there's something that's been stirring up in me. Even as we sing these songs, I've heard these songs before on Christmas CDs, on iTunes, whatever, but something's connecting with me different. Even when I see the story or hear your story, something's connecting with me. And what I'm saying, that's the Holy Spirit prodding on your heart to say, hey, you don't have to do life apart from me. Why don't you accept my gift of salvation to you? So if you're here today and you're tired of trying things on your own, there's so much what it seems like chaos and all types of stuff going on in your life that doesn't necessarily make sense. But one thing that does make sense is you know this Jesus can change that all. You don't know how, but you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. It would hurt my heart if you come here and hear about Christmas unwrapped and you don't unwrap the gift of salvation this evening for yourself to know Him as your Savior. But if you're here and you're saying, you know what? I want to commit my life to this Jesus. I know what that transformation was like. Many of the artists you hear today know what that transformation is like. And if you're here and you want to experience that transformation for yourself, would you be so kind to pray this prayer silently in your heart after me? Or maybe you fell away from the Lord. You were walking with the Lord at one time. Maybe you grew up around the church like I did, but you strayed off. Today is your day to come back and to know Jesus for yourself. Would you pray this prayer after me if you want to accept Jesus into your life as your personal Lord and Savior, and it no longer just be a theory, but a personal relationship with you? Pray this prayer with me silently in your heart. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Change me. Wash away my sins that I may know you, that I may live for you, that you may be king of my life for the rest of my life. I accept this gift of salvation this evening. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Can I ask you to do something bold? I just want to celebrate with you. If you prayed that prayer for the first time, or you just prayed that prayer with me to dedicate your life to Christ, would you do something bold? I know it's crowded in here, and we still have some great stuff to come that's not over. But if you prayed with me, would you do something bold? Would you slip your hand up and say, Pastor, I prayed with you this evening. Anyone here pray with me? I see that hand in the overflow right here. Right here, I see those hands. I see those hands. Praise God. Awesome. In the balcony, I see those hands all over the place. Praise God. Awesome. Awesome. There's one key thing I want you to do when we're dismissed. On the way out, you're going to see individuals with this next step packet. Please do me a favor. Grab this packet. And this packet's a gift from us to you. It helps you explain the decision you made. There's some literature in here. It's a free gift on our behalf to you. So if you pray with me and you're saying, you know what, Pastor? I meant business with God this evening. I want you to grab this on the way out. Just simply grab it. Take it. Read it. Go over the information in this packet. But again, I want to congratulate you for unwrapping the best gift that you can unwrap this Christmas. And that's the gift of salvation and knowing Jesus personally. But be sure to take this on the way out. Well, they have some phenomenal songs and pieces to share with us still. How many of you are enjoying it so far? Awesome. So am I. Let's continue to have Christmas unwrapped.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your
Greatest gift came flesh wrapped, straight from Bethlehem. Who would expect that? Shepherds and wise men followed the stars in the distance. Brought the child gifts like gold and fresh incense. The world needed a king, came in the form of a babe, because we were slaves and we needed him to show us the way. He came in heaven, smiled, saw God grinning, born in a small town. Yeah, humble beginnings. Yeah, he was born in a manger. Didn't know he'd grow up to be my savior. But Mary knew she pushed love when she labored. Heart full of conviction from the sign God gave her. And now we're here like thousands of years later. And we can still hear the sounds of the angels. Glory in the highest, giving all praise to the newborn king. And we agree when we say,
glory in the highest, say glory.
now it's my solo. I'm just kidding with you. I was not gonna run you out of here. Well, hopefully you all are enjoying the concert thus far. Can we just give a round of applause again for all that has happened already? At this point, I would like to just take up a gift and an offering first of all, just help offset some of the cost that goes into the concert. But more importantly, what you saw, that video that you saw with the Abigail House, when you sow towards our church, that helps us to fund what God has put on our heart missionally. We're a church that's very involved in the community, very involved in doing outreach and missions and really serving felt needs. And when you sow and you get a gift together, and there's five ways to give. If you're writing out a check, you can make it payable to Christ Church. But when you sow, you're helping us to fund great efforts like the Abigail House, where there's been plenty of families impacted by that home. And so when you sow, that helps us offset even the cost that goes to running the Abigail House, so on and so forth. But there are many, many missions that we are involved in. So as you get your gift together, I do want to let you know that if you're looking for a place of worship, we do have four services here at the East Campus. We're one church with two locations, but one in Rockaway, New Jersey, one here in Montclair. We have a Saturday night 7 p.m. service, a Sunday at 9:30, 11:30, and 1:30. Again, that's Saturday night 7 p.m., and Sunday 9:30 a.m., 11:30 a.m., and 1:30 p.m. And so we have four services. You could decide to worship here. And the reason why we have so many services is so you don't have an excuse not to come to church. Okay. Now, I'm just kidding. So hopefully you can just choose one of those if you're looking for a place to worship. Do you mind as I pray over the gifts this evening? Lord, it is such a privilege to worship you in an environment like this. We don't take for granted the gift that you gave through your son. And we ask that you bless our gift, our material gifts, as we sow towards your work to keep your mission at the forefront of what we do as a church. I thank you for these gifts, and I ask that you bless the givers. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, also, if you're kind of saying, hey, what's going on here around Christmas Eve and New Year's, what you should have received on the way in is this pamphlet. And if you look through it, read through it, it'll show you some of our service times during Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve. We like to go into the New Year's with a bang, so to speak. You can find our service times at that point. Now, how many of you would like to hear a little bit of an encore really quickly? An encore, encore, encore. Can you guys give us a little bit of an encore? Let me see.
Oh, come on, you faithful.
Oh, come on, you faithful.
Oh, come on, you faithful.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Can we thank our choir, our band, media team, everyone who worked so hard to put this together? This was truly a Christmas Unwrapped. Well, church, let me be one of the first people to say to wish you Merry Christmas. Have a great evening. Hope you enjoyed the concert. Tell a friend to come tomorrow night if they missed it today. Have a great evening, y'all. God bless.